The First Lady was burdened by the plight of vulnerable women and children. She therefore mobilized women from all walks of life through an organization she founded called Uganda Women's Effort to Save Orphans.
Prime Minister Robinah Nabbanja is in Tokyo, Japan for 4 days on a working visit where she is representing the First Lady, Janet Museveni, at the Asia Pacific and African Women Economic Summit for First Ladies from these countries. Nabbanja, who is representing the country at the summit, noted that food insecurity adversely affects the growth and education of children and consequently leads to school dropouts, among other challenges.
Uganda's experience in addressing food insecurity in schools. Ladies and gentlemen, as we are all aware, food security and education are amongst the key investments that contribute towards the attainment of the sustainable development goals, especially development goal 1 to 5, which includes no poverty, zero hunger.
She asked the international community to support Uganda's efforts to host refugees from the neighboring countries.
A total of 1.5 million people are in Uganda as refugees who come from our neighboring countries. They come to Uganda in search for their life because some of our neighboring countries are insecure. This is therefore to request for some more support from the international community. Because since the Ukraine and Russian war, the support to Uganda is quite dwindling, and therefore we request for support.
The Prime Minister, while delivering her message on behalf of the First Lady, lauded Mrs. Museveni for initiating programs such as UESO that played a great role in helping vulnerable women and children. Zimbabwe's First Lady, Auxilia Mnangagwa, and other First Ladies shared their views on food security and how the situation can be addressed. These challenges include the three C's: climate change, COVID-19, and conflict.
Zimbabwe continues to prioritize food and nutrition security. In this regard, a raft of policies supported through the national fiscus have been put in place towards reforming, mechanizing, and modernizing agriculture.
In a country like Malawi, any sustainable solution to the food crisis must aim at increasing access to nutritious food through programs that enable the households of these children to either produce enough food or buy food of their own.
The Japan International Cooperation Agency, JICA, pledges for more support to countries to address food security concerns and also improve the livelihoods of the people.
JICA will expand its cooperation of food and nutrition in order to make African people to access sufficient and nourished food, protect the children who will bear the future, and promote the further empowerment of women in Africa.
The summit has attracted First Ladies and women leaders from Africa, Asia, and the Pacific, and is running under the theme to cope with food crisis for the future of children by mothers. The premiere will tomorrow, Tuesday, continue with this summit where various development partners will showcase. Report by Ismail Kasoha for the news. 1, 2, 3! 1, 2, 3!